A revolution is something that changes the world. There was a revolution in Concord, a revolution in Paris, and now there's a revolution going on in America.
Look around our shul and you see the number of people that are using the art scroll Chumashim, the art scroll Siddurim, and not to mention the art scroll Shas, the Daf Yomi edition, and you realize that this has really become a mainstay of our community.
One of the first things that I notice when I walk into a shul is you're always going to find the art scroll Siddur, and that has always been very important to me, having been in a couple of communities and traveling on business, to be able to walk into any shul and pick up a siddur that you know and be able to participate in davening in a smooth and easy way, no matter where you are in the country.
I love the interlinear, where it has the translation right underneath. So, I mean, I do read Hebrew, but I don't necessarily understand it. And to be able to read each sentence and to be able to see underneath it exactly what I'm reading is a huge benefit.
I can say without overestimation that there are thousands upon thousands of people for whom the interlinear series has enhanced their tefillah, enhanced their study of Chumash, enhanced specialized tefillos such as Slichos and Kinos.
Now, many of us, we have bar mitzvahs and we don't look at another page in Hebrew until later on in life, and then to actually be able to relearn Hebrew by looking at the Hebrew and the English, it's something really phenomenal.
For me, as a mom and a housewife and running a Jewish home, the most exciting thing for me is when Art School comes out with a new cookbook. And the books are beautifully presented and well-researched, and the recipes are just wonderful.
Rabbi Zlotowitz and Rabbi Sherman, you know, when they first started in a small room with a very small svarim, they never dreamt themselves that it would come to this worldwide acceptance in many languages.
We have seen numerous times unsolicited emails, phone calls that we get from people who say that these publications have changed their lives, have given them an ability to learn in a way that they never could have done before.
People have this misconception is, I'm there, they're in this strange language, I don't understand. Well, the answer is right in front of you. Open up the art scroll, read the translation, read the summaries, read the explanations of why this word is used instead of this word, or, you know, why is this repeated, and you've got it.
I remember my first shiur, my knees were knocking together and I was so nervous, but truthfully, with the help of Art Scroll, I have to spend much less time than I would spend without the help of Art Scroll.
You know, if you look at publications, Jewish publications, and you go back 500 years ago, there was a man named Daniel Bomberg in Venice who printed the Bomberg Talmud. And he published his Talmud, and now 500 years later, people look at it, and it's a major collection piece. The objective of Art Scroll is not to be a major collector piece, it's to be a user piece. And they'll remember that Art Scroll is the one who ignited the flames for more learning in this country, and that they'll go down as a people who have produced more Torah in a given location in any time in Jewish history.
The Belzer Beis Medrash in Yerushalayim has 60 sets of the Hebrew Schottenstein Talmud. And who said that they should be there? The Rebbe himself.
Perhaps one of the most warming things is to go to Eretz Yisrael, visit people of the stature of Rav Eliashiv or Rav Chaim Kanievsky, and to see them studying from our various editions of the Talmud, in Hebrew, of course, And you know you've done it right when they feel it's an important contribution.
Our Gemara, by opening up the material to everybody, giving the details, the background, the setup, the layout, the typesetting, everything, closes that gap, makes a person want to learn, being able to learn, and makes the experience comfortable. Once the experience is comfortable, he'll do it again and again till he gets identified with the material.
The Shas is, after all, has been said by secular writers, the portable homeland of the Jewish people. Wherever in our Golus we went, wherever in our exile we ended up, the Jewish people were able to get together in the shul at night or in the morning and open up the Talmud, and they were back in the land of their fathers.
And Baruch Hashem, September of 2007, I was able to complete the Daf Yomi. And what's amazing about it is, without Art Scroll, it would have never happened. Because I travel a lot, and when I was, whether I was in Hawaii, or I was in France, or I was in Spain, or whatever it was, I had my Art Scroll with me, and I was able to go through the Hebrew, or the Aramaic, and the English, and that's the only way I could get through, otherwise it would have been impossible.
Hashem planted in every generation the seeds for the continuity of Torah at that time, at that point in history. And one of those seeds is the Schottenstein Talmud.
It's a lens into Torah that Poshet Yidden like myself will have access to the Chachamim. Without a yeshiva education, how could you hope to do it, you know? With that, you can do it.
Meir Zlotowicz to the Jewish world is like Gutenberg was to the printed word. The number of people that are able to learn, can access learning, you know, has I think grown exponentially since the advent of Art Scroll.
I went up to Mr. Schottenstein and I said, I want to thank you for my learning. I couldn't have done it without your Gemaras. I couldn't have done it. I just couldn't have done it. I said, it's opened up a world for me.
They have spread it out to many more people who until now didn't even open up these Gemaras because they couldn't make heads and tails out of it. And so it really became that the Schottenstein Shas was able to expand to Melamed Torah, Lame Yisrael.
Who could have imagined in the few short decades since Art Scroll was founded that it would have such a profound impact in the United States, in the Western Hemisphere, but also around the world? I cannot tell you how many times I am surprised, whether it's a government official's office, a businessman, a lawyer's bookshelf, that I see Art Scroll Svarim prominently displayed.
I recently had a meeting with Senator Joe Lieberman in his hideaway in the United States Capitol, and what did I see on his bookshelf? A few volumes of the Art Scroll Schottenstein Talmud. A few weeks later, I hosted an event for a senator in New York, and Ellie Kleinman was there. I introduced him to another attendee there, and the guy goes, oh, are you Kleinman from the Kleinman Daily Dose of Torah? I study your book every day. This is from a fellow who I did not know had a connection to Yiddishkeit. Art Scroll continues to make a tremendous difference in our world.
There isn't a plane that I'm traveling on, be it from New York to Bangladesh or Bangladesh to Sri Lanka or Hong Kong to China, that I don't have somebody on that plane that's opening up a Gemara, taking out a Gemara, be it the large size Gemara in English or in Hebrew, or the small size Gemara, or now the wonderful paperback Gemaras that I personally use and travel in my suitcase. So it's really firsthand, the guy that travels as much as I can tell you firsthand the impact that Art Scroll has had on this generation.
The corporate governance of Art Scroll, of Masara Heritage Foundation, actually, because that equally impressive to me to see an organization that is run so professionally from a corporate governance perspective.
Projects like Art Scroll are unique, and today that's what we're looking for. Something different. Something that you can give a message to thousands of thousands of people. Art Scroll has the power. And that's why Art Scroll is the right tool.
This is a cause that actually unites the Jewish people. The Torah is for everybody. If you look at the Torah, it doesn't say the Torah is meant for this class of Jews. It's meant for all Jews. And for me, that's actually a very emotional thing, and it's very important for my children to see that.
Look at the Art Scroll page. The graphics, the design, the fonts. There's genius here. The genius behind the scenes is Shia Brander.
The Pasuk says, "Derechei Adach Einoyam." Its ways are the ways of pleasantness. We were very fortunate to be able to bring this tremendous pleasantness and clarity to the words of the Torah.
One goal everyone who's working on every one of the projects has is a passion for excellence. They can spend days sometimes on trying to pick just that right word that will try to encompass what the Talmud or the Medrash or any of the other volumes are trying to teach us in a way that's multi-nuanced. If you don't do that, all you're doing is taking a phrase from one language into the other and preserving the ambiguity. Here, the precision is the goal.
These scholars are the most outstanding scholars imaginable. The rooms they sit in are, to me, Kodesh Kodashim. They're the ultimate in scholarship.
There's a legacy here that goes far beyond what's on the bookshelf. There will be entire families that are connected to Klal Yisrael because of what we're doing here today.
We're in the middle now of the Schottenstein edition of the Talmud Yerushalmi, Hebrew and English. Yerushalmi was completed 1,650 years ago. It's much more difficult than the Bavli. So difficult that hardly anybody has been able to learn it over the years except for the very great scholars. And now it's being made available to everybody. That's history.
The Schottenstein edition Yerushalmi project is unique in the sense that it's really touching upon Yerushalmi, which has been a closed book for thousands of years. And now with the Schottenstein edition, study groups are forming all over the world.
Nice thing is that Yerushalmi is being opened up to people who never dreamed that they would have been able to use it.
Until now, Yerushalmi was probably done by very few people. And I would assume most of them became frustrated that they really didn't have it. And now it became available that even the Bnei Torah and the big Talmid HaChamim and the Gene Hadea are praising it, that it opened it for them. So listen, if they appreciate it and they feel it opened it something for them, then it must be a very good payoff.
So it's no big deal to write the check, send the wire in, make sure it happens. To actually make the thing come back to life, you got to make sure that it's available to people. I can't force people to learn it, but I can make it available. And I've been doing that on multiple continents, multiple cities, multiple places.
For French-speaking Jews, 15 volumes of the Edmund J. Safra edition of the Talmud have already been published, with many more to come. And the Edmund J. Safra Chumash is inspiring hearts and minds in Israel, France, and Canada.
I'm convinced that this project, the Chumash in Spanish, would have a tremendous impact in all the Spanish-speaking Jewry around the world, which is the third largest community in terms of languages in the Jewish world.
Medrash has for a long time been a relatively closed book. There are many Hebrew commentaries on it, but an English language treatment in depth has really not been there.
The motto of Masorah Heritage Foundation is the written word is forever. And indeed that's the case. There's very few things that one could do today that will still be here and vibrant and in libraries in 300, 400, 500 years from now.
The story of 2011 and 2012 is revolution. Some peaceful, most violent, but most of them are ending in disappointment. Not the Art Scroll revolution. Baruch Hashem, it's still going strong.